So this is not easy as we take. Time is the most important value. So number one, Allah says, you have to have a belief. And what is that belief? What's that belief? The belief towards the right attitude of theology and dogma. That is belief. And what's that? إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And accept the one who believe. They're not in loss. It's a context. It's a text of the context. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَةِ. First you believe and then do righteous deeds. You have a belief, you do righteous deeds, you are acceptable. If you do not have a belief, you do righteous deeds, you are a hypocrite. If you have a belief and you do not do righteous deeds, you are a mujrimun, criminal in the sight of God. So nothing will be accepted. Both ways you are in khasara, loss. Unless you have a belief, then you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, وَتَوَاسَوْ بِالْحَقِّ إِنَّمَا اللَّهُنْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَلَا تَقُولُ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْحَقِّ. Do not say anything except truth about Allah, that your God is one God. He is alone. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. He is alone. And وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. The last verse, and nothing is like unto him. In this capital H. Allah says that this is the criterion which you will be accepted. Belief, then righteous deeds. And then to accept the truth, don't say anything. وَتَوَاسَوْ بِالْحَقِّ. And call people towards truth. وَتَوَاسَوْ بِالصَّبْرِ. And call people towards perseverance. Chapter 2, verse 155, Allah says, and we will test you of hunger, fear, which you don't know, loss of the children, the lives, and we will see who is sabirin. Inna Allah ma'as sabirin. And we will see that who is amongst the most in the patience and perseverance. Allah is giving you this test to check you who is the best. Not that everything you have to get in this world on the spot. Allah says in the Quran, if I were to punish you one by one according to your deeds on the right time, in the right moment, nothing must breathe. Nothing must be, you know, living that breathes. Everything will be finished. But Allah has given the dynamic system, the system of everything, that you do something evil, sometimes you get punished on the time. But sometimes the punishment has been respited. And ulama says that the respited punishment is the worst than the punishment you get in the dunya. Meaning, if something Allah punishes you for some particular reason, it is better to get punished in this dunya than in the akhirah, where the time is so long that the punishment is so cruel. So this is what the concept. We should be thankful. And how would we know that something, a trial, calamity has fallen on me? Is it the wrath of Allah? Is it the punishment of Allah? Or it is the test of Allah? This is the biggest dilemma people face. Look, it's very simple. Any trial, calamity, tribulation come to you, and for this reason, you come towards Allah, nearer to Allah than before, then it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If that calamity and test makes you away from Allah, that is the punishment or wrath of Allah towards you. So you have to decide what is your reaction towards that calamity. Are you coming near to Allah? Then you are blessed. If you are going away to Allah, you are cursed. So in all the matters of life, we should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever He has given us, whatever qadr Allah wa ma sha fa'al. So thanks to Allah, whatever qadr He has destined for me, that is the part of the faith and test too. So you teach other people perseverance, patience. If he's in a calamity, try to teach him perseverance. That if something unjust happened to you and you are failed to do justice, look, if there is no Islamic system to help you, leave it to Allah, the day of Akhirah. That day is worse than the current day. So if the people think that, you know, I can do something unjust to someone else and nobody can catch me, then, you know, make sure that you get the punishment in this dunya. Because if you leave this ma'amla to akhirah, that will be the worst, I can say that worst. So this is what Allah says, and this is the small summary of that surah.